Hello everyone, and today I'm going to create an authorization screen using only the interface builder. This is our screen in portrait orientation. Here is our screen in landscape orientation. We can clearly see that elements have different position on both screens. And the question is, how do we move all of these elements from one screen to another? To do this task, I'm going to use the size class. Classes help elements to adapt to different screens. Make your work much simple. So let's get started. First, let's create the app. Type a name for your project that you're going to use. In the interface, make sure storyboard is selected. Save your project. Then let's go to the main storyboard. Make sure the view is chosen. And add the text label. Type text, enter passcode. So after you have typed in the text, let's add some constraints. Click constraints, put the width 195 and the height 20. The label should be horizontally centered in the safe area and top to the safe area as well. Then let's add size class between top and safe and text label. Then let's set the distance for the landscape orientation and put the size class as well. Let's check how the spacing works on different models of iPhone. It works pretty fine in every model we check in both portrait and landscape orientation. Now it's time to add the circles, and I will use horizontal stack for it. As an upper constraint, width 195 and height 20. Align the stack horizontally and add the spacing for the stack 15. Each circle will be a separate view, so let's add 6 views to the horizontal stack. Set the width 20 to every circle. To turn the view into circle, I will add a separate Swift file and call it round view. Let's also create a round view extension where we will specify what will happen to the view. Import the UI kit. Create the UI view extension. And add the function make rounded with 2 parameters in it. In function, we will have to specify the corner radius of the layer. We also have to specify the border color. Finally, we add the border width to the function. Let's open the RoundView file now and import the UI kit there. Let's add the class RoundView. And add the function awake from nip. Inside of it, we add make rounded function and mention dark text and border width 1.
Each view should be assigned the round view class. And in the simulator, we get the circles that we desired. Let's create the round view button class that we're gonna use for the number pad. Import the UI kit. Create the class round view button. Override awake from nib function. Add make rounded function inside of it. The parameters will stay the same. For the buttons, I'm going to add vertical step view. Put 44 as the top constraint, 80 and height 350. Center the step view horizontally and add the size class for the portrait orientation. In landscape, we don't have the step view. Put the spacing 10 to the step view and add the buttons. Add the button style, make the font size 45, text dark, and make it centered. Round button class to the button. And now it's time to add the rest three buttons to the stack view. The height of each button should be 80. Add the style to the rest of the buttons as we did with the first one. And we get the result. Let's add the rest two stacks to the screen. For the left stack, the trailing constraint is 20. Add another size class. And put the buttons inside. Let's add the last stack for the portrait orientation. Align this stack on the top with the middle stack. Let's check the simulator. It looks good, and don't forget to add the size classes to the stack. Let's add the delete label now. Put the constraint height 30, and bottom constraint will be 20 in the portrait orientation. Align delete label with the right stack view. And now let's see what we have on the simulator. It looks as we expected. Add size class to delete bottom constraint. For landscape orientation, let's make bottom constraint 12. Now it's time to add the stack views to the landscape orientation. Make top constraint 30, width 520 and height 80. align the stack horizontally then. As in portrait orientation we did, now it's time to add the buttons inside the stack view. The buttons will have the same configuration as in portrait orientation. Now let's add the second stack view. To both of the stacks, the size classes should be assigned as in portrait orientation. And here is the result.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was useful for you and see you in the next videos.